Yes, friends, good morning. Welcome again in Rattu Tota. Today we will discuss a very important sampling theorem that is used to convert basically continuous time signal into discrete time signal. So first of all, we have to know what is the continuous time signal and what is the meaning of the discrete time signal. So continuous time signal is basically the signal which have the infinite number of amplitude values, infinite number of amplitude values at each and every value of the time instance. This is your time scale and this is your amplitude scale, okay. Now we have infinite number of amplitudes at each and every axis. That means infinite number of values we are having at each and every time instance. For example, t equals 0, 1, 2, 3 up to infinite. At any value we have sum of the amplitude values. So this is the meaning for the continuous time signal, that is the continuous over the time axis. Continuous over the time axis, we have the infinite amplitude values at each and every time instance of the time axis, okay. This is the meaning of the continuous time signal. What is the meaning of the discrete time signals? This is your impulse train, okay. This is your impulse train that many impulses are aligned in equal intervals of time, ts, 2ts, 3ts, 4ts. Ts means sampling period, this means sampling time, sampling time period. This is another question, what is the difference between continuous time signal and discrete time signal? We have to multiply this impulse train with the continuous time signal. Now we will get the signal that is called the discrete time signal at particular time intervals. This is particular time intervals, we have the amplitude values. That means time axis is discretized. Time axis is discretized. At particular time intervals, that is T0, T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, T6, T7, T8, up to some limited number of time instants, we have amplitudes. We have amplitudes. That is the meaning of the discrete time signal. Simply, we generate a sequence that is known as the impulse train, then multiply this impulse train with the our continuous time signal, and where it touches at amplitude, we will get this signal. T is equal to Ts, T equals to 2Ts, T equals to 3Ts, 4Ts, 5Ts, up to the nTs, we are getting our signal that is known as the discrete time signal. Now the important question comes in RTU examination. Find the critical sampling frequency and sampling interval for the following signals. So what is the meaning of the sampling period? Sampling period ka matlab f of s, that is your sampling frequency, always greater than equals to twice of f of m, that is your modulating frequency or the baseband frequency. जो फ्रीक्वेंसी जिस कंटिन्यूस टाइम सिग्नल की फ्रीक्वेंसी है उसका डबल होना चाहिए हमारा कौन सा सैम्पलिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी. और वी कैन से टी एस मस्ट बी लेस देन इक्वल्स टू वन अपॉन ट्वाइस ऑफ एफ एम. जो टाइम इंटरवल हम लोगों ने लिया है इम्पल्स ट्रेन का, या हम लोग इससे मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे, उस इम्पल्स ट्रेन का टाइम पीरियड लेस देन इक्वल्स टू वन अपॉन ट्वाइस ऑफ एफ एम. दिस इज द मैंडेटरी कंडीशन फॉर द सैम्पलिंग थ्योरम, ओके, गॉट इट. So we have to find out this twice of fm. Signals given, first signal is f of t equals to cos of 2 pi into 10 ki power 3 t plus cos of 6 pi into 10 ki power 3 t, iska whole square given hai. So you have to find out the sampling frequency or Nyquist frequency, sampling interval of this signal. So first you have to evaluate the signal f of t. F of t will be equals to first one, cos square of 2 pi into 10 ki power 3 t plus cos square 6 pi into 10 ki power 3 t plus twice of cos of 2 pi into 10 ki power 3 t cos of 6 pi into 10 की पावर 3 t, cos square a plus cos square b plus twice of cos a cos b. cos A cos A cos B, again we have to evaluate this cos A cos B. Cos A cos B means cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Cos A plus B 6 pi plus 2 pi is your 8 pi. So cos of 8 pi into 10 ki power 3 t plus cos of 6 pi minus 2 pi, that is your 4 pi into 10 ki power 3 t. You have to find out the maximum frequency component present in the signal, that is the maximum component. Cos square 2 pi into 10 ki power 3 t, cos square 6 pi into 10 ki power 3 t, 8 pi into 10 ki power 3 t. This is individual signal, this is again individual signal, this is again individual, and this is also individual. Cos square 6 pi into 10 ki power 3 t, this may be the maximum frequency component present in the signal. How? Cos square, we can explain 1 plus cos of twice of 6 pi into 10 ki power 3 t. This signal can be the maximum frequency component. 8 pi less than, 4 pi less, all again less, 2 pi the lowest frequency component, and this is 12 pi, that is cos of 12 pi into 10 ki power 3 t. This is maybe the maximum frequency component. So how can you find out the sampling frequency? Sampling frequency is equals to twice of fm. So 12 pi into 10 ki power 3 t will be equals to 2 pi fm. 2 se 2 cancel, pi se pi cancel. fm will be 6 into 10 ki power 3 into 3. fm will be equals to 6 into 10 ki power 3 hertz, or we can say samples per second. So we are getting fm, that is your maximum frequency component present in the signal. Fm will be equals to 6 into 10 ki power 3. So the sampling frequency will be equals to fs will be 2 into 6 into 10 ki power 3, that is your 12 into 10 ki power 3 samples per second. This is the right answer for the first problem. F of t equals to cos of 2 pi into 10 ki power 3 t plus, we are taking the maximum possibility of the questions coming in the R2 examination. Second question, that is a sampling signal, sampling of 500 pi t plus sampling of 800 pi t. How can you solve? I am rubbing this right side. Second one is sampling of 500 pi t, sampling of 800 pi t. Simply 800 pi t is maximum, so sampling of 800 pi t. Okay, sampling of 800 pi t. Sampling means simply sine function, sine of pi t upon pi t. This is your sampling function. This is your sampling function. The sampling of 800 pi t will have the maximum component. F of m will be equals to 800 hertz. Okay, 800 hertz, or we can say, sorry, two pi fm we will get 800 pi. T से T cancel हो जाएगा, FM will be equals to 800 pi upon 2 pi, that is pi to pi cancel, that is your 400 hertz. Now sampling frequency will be equals to twice of FM, that is your 800 samples per second is your sampling frequency or Nyquist frequency. The third one is cos square 2 pi, sorry, third one is 100 sinc square 100 t. Again this is square, sinc function, what is the meaning of sinc function? SINC will be equals to sine of t upon t. That is the meaning of sinc function. So sinc square, that is your sinc square 100t will be equals to tan sinc 100t multiply with tan sinc 100t. So the maximum frequency, that is your 200t. Maximum frequency component is 200t. So the FM will be equals to, FM will be equals to 100 of hertz or samples per second. Samples per second. So sampling frequency or Nyquist frequency will be equals to twice of FM. That will be equals to 200 hertz. This is very important question, many times comes in RTU examination, the find out the sampling frequency or Nyquist frequency of the given signal. We have to search the maximum frequency component present in the whole signal, whether it is one component, two component or three component. If there are two components, then we have to search one component. If have to more than two components, then also you have to search one component out of three components. So by this way, we can find out the sampling frequency of the given signal. I think you understood the problem very well. Thank you friends for watching this video. Thank you so much.